Okay, this is the last chapter of Leaf Blower Man. Very exciting day. It is the time I reveal the handoff of the lithium battery leaf blower to Leaf Blower Man, my neighbor. Now, if you haven't seen the first part, go watch it now and you'll get caught up to speed on this thing. So I promised I would deliver a leaf blower to our neighbor who has been using a 30-year-old gas-powered leaf blower where you mix the oil and the gas. So let me tell you, this thing couldn't have gone better. I was worried I didn't want to get into a Rand Paul bad neighbor situation. It was the last day of autumn. I went out there, I was raking leaves the old-fashioned way. He was probably getting ready to fire up his leaf blower. And I said, I've got a gift for you. And here's how it went. It was as if it was Christmas morning and he was opening up a Tonka truck. He quickly took it back to the garage, powered it up, I guess it comes powered, and started using it. And it just went great. He was so happy. And I had explained to him that I wasn't too happy with, you know, all the noise all these years and the exhaust coming in the house. And he was very apologetic and said, wow, well, I got to pay you for this thing. I said, no, don't pay me. This was given to me by the company, Ego, who was kind enough to supply the leaf blower as part of this promotional exchange. And it is a fantastic leaf blower. He even let me use it. So I went in the back and it took me about 30 seconds to dust off my back driveway. I've got to get one. So what have we learned here? One thing I've learned is that with the exception of airplanes, I don't think there's any reason to be burning petroleum to run our stuff anymore. I've driven the Tesla, I've seen this leaf blower, it's just as powerful as the other one. I think the internal combustion engine with all of its camshafts and pistons and valves and stuff is gonna go the way of the typewriter. And for those of you under 30, a typewriter is one of those contraptions we used to use to type our thoughts on a piece of paper. We didn't have emojis, so we just had to actually think up stuff to tell people how we feel and then use it for our term papers or to send a letter to somebody. And a letter is something we used to put a stamp on and lick, and for 13 cents, you could send it anywhere in the country in about 3 days. So he loves this thing. It is. He was out there the next day, and he was blowing all his leaves onto the street so that they can be taken away to their final resting place, courtesy of our property tax dollars. It was fantastic. So here we are in winter, and we have about a week left on this charity. We've raised close to $2,000, and let's try to get the thing even up higher. Last week, if you haven't dropped a dime in the bucket, do so. It's really a good cause. We take water for granted in most parts of this country. You turn on your tap, and water magically appears. And in some parts of the world, it's just not like that. They really struggle with clean water. And Charity Water is a great organization who installs wells in these developing countries so that the communities have access to clean water. So let's get these kids some clean water. If you haven't donated already, you've got another week to do it. Let's get the totals up a little more. So I don't know what the magic formula is to get things to go viral, to get a million views. Usually it involves a cat doing something goofy. But I did shoot this at a friend's the other day of a little dog playfully dragging a dog three times its weight across the floor. I thought that was pretty funny. So maybe that's good enough to share with everybody in the name of Charity Water, in the name of a good cause. Thank you all for participating in my little silly video with Leaf Blower Man. I think it all worked out great. He's got a new leaf blower. He's gonna retire that old one. It's gonna be a lot quieter on the block. The link is below for the donations, and I'll play out with a little Vince Guaraldi Christmas music.